A rescue operation is now underway in the waters of Japan and South Korea for crew members of a cargo ship that capsized early Wednesday. Joint rescue teams from Tokyo and Seoul said 14 crew members of the vessel have been rescued. 8 others remain missing. The Japanese Coast Guard says the vessel had 14 Chinese nationals and 8 from Myanmar. The ship was identified as the Jintian and is registered in Hong Kong. It sank 3 hours after it sent a distress call when it was in the waters between Nagasaki in Japan and South Korea's Jeju Island. North Korea orders a lockdown in its capital amid rising cases of an unspecified respiratory illness. A government notice did not specify if this is due to a new COVID outbreak. But residents in Pyongyang were told to stay in their homes for 5 days and to submit themselves to daily temperature checks. North Korea acknowledged its first COVID outbreak in May last year, but declared victory over the virus by August. Authorities say a Siberian cold snap is sweeping the country, which has brought down temperatures to as low as negative 22 degrees Celsius. Classified government papers recovered at the home of former U.S. Vice President Mike Pence. U.S. media reports the documents were recovered at his Indiana residence last week. Pence's lawyer says the files have been turned over to the Federal Bureau of Investigation and they have alerted the National Archives. The level of sensitivity or classification of the documents was not immediately available. Now, this development puts Pence in the company of former President Donald Trump and President Joe Biden. Both are facing special counsel investigations by the Justice Department over the improper handling of classified materials. Manila's envoy to Washington reveals talks are underway for joint U.S. and Philippine maritime patrols in the West Philippine Sea. Ambassador Jose Manuel Romualdez says the defense cooperation collaboration will be carried out under the visiting forces agreement.
We are looking at all possibilities in terms of enhancing our defense capabilities. Joint patrols is like the VFA. Visiting Forces Agreement, we have our joint exercises. So joint patrols is something that is also part and parcel of that agreement that we have with the United States. So we will let you know, and I'm sure you will know, when the joint patrols will take place.
U.S. Ambassador to the Philippines Mark A. Carlson, meanwhile, says establishing peace and security in the region is part of U.S. President Joe Biden's Indo-Pacific strategy. Senator Francis Tolentino backing the push for a joint maritime patrol by the Philippines and the U.S. He says it's time for such efforts given the recent reports of alleged Chinese harassment of Filipino fishermen in Philippine waters.
I have been espousing that to have joint U.S.-Philippine Coast Guard patrols, but we might even extend that to be a multilateral patrol to include other ASEAN claimants to ensure the freedom of navigation, exercise of fishing rights, among others. It is alarming because 2 incidents involving a small fishing vessel of the Philippines and a big vessel of the Chinese Coast Guard. It's not just intimidating, but life-threatening for our Filipino fishermen.